together, people here in Lingelis, in Credoc, actually, we're very much united. And Fort was the president of the youth association. And the youth was so disciplined. They were just disciplined young people in Credoc. Because of the efforts that they have put in the youth.
On the night of June 27, 1985, Matthew Goniwe, Sparrow Mkonto, Fort Calata and Sitkelo Mhlauli left a UDF meeting in Port Elizabeth and set out to drive home to Cradock. They were never seen alive again. Their mutilated, charred corpses were discovered days later in three different places along the Eastern Cape coastline.
With help from black security police reinforcements, they executed them one by one.
Being politically active in the rural areas during the years of apartheid was to be dangerously conspicuous. Teachers Matthew Goniwe and Fort Calata mobilized the youth and community of a small town called Cradock, making it a focal point of anti-apartheid resistance. They soon became targets of the security police. On June the 27th, 1985, on their way home from a political meeting, Matthew and Fort, along with two colleagues, disappeared.
You know,
Izzy, I am captain of a ship. And being captain of a ship, I could in fact perform a mariage right here, right on this deck.